Hi dancers, welcome to our very special online ballet class. This class is for my elementary students, mostly for elementary one, but elementary two can do this as well. I will be putting up some more exercises for elementary two and especially 2B bar exercises in another video. But for now, you can follow along with this. So let's get started. We'll start with our silly stretches. Taking your foot to rock your baby. Kiss your baby. I just blow a kiss. Touch your baby to your head. And put your baby on top of your head. Other foot, rock your baby. Kiss your baby. Touch your baby to your head. Put your baby on top of your head. Now two babies at once. Kiss two babies. Touch two babies to your head. And put two babies on top of your head. Let's put the babies in the crib and kiss them goodnight. All right, sitting up nice and tall, we'll do all our silly feet. Pencils, stop signs, duck feet, bananas. Pencils, stop signs, duck feet, bananas. While you're doing this, make sure you have a nice tall ballet back and that you're not a couch potato. Pencils, stop signs, duck feet, bananas. Now we'll do scissors and window wipers. All right, reach for your toes and pull up. Reach for your toes again and pull up. Okay, now we're going to do this silly one that I like, where we grab our ankles and we point our feet and look down, and we flex our feet and look up. Down, up, down, up, down, up, and if you want, you can go fast. And that makes me dizzy, so follower. All right, nicely done. Let's stretch our legs out to the side now. We're going to paint a rainbow today. So have your invisible finger paint behind each foot. And we'll start with red. Paint a rainbow. Orange. Yellow. Green. Blue. And purple. Now, do you know what holiday was just a few days ago? St. Patrick's Day. So I'm going to take a pot of gold and slide it under the rainbow and take a little nap. All right, sit up nice and tall. Let's do some cat and cow backs. So on all fours, we look down at our belly button for a cat back. Arch your back and look up at the ceiling for a cow back.
Cat back.
Cow back.
Cat back.
Cow back. Now we're going to reach our leg out way, way straight behind us and lift our leg really high. Make sure that knee is straight and foot is pointed. Do you remember why we do this? That's right. This is for leaps, so we can have straight legs when we leap. Now let's do our other leg. Lift it up really straight. Can you tell if your foot is pointed? Wiggle it around if you're not sure. How about your knee straight? If you're not sure, bend it and then straight. Good. Now we'll do our cobras. Hands underneath shoulders. Lift up your head. Squeeze your legs together to make a snake tail. Lift up your head, stick out your tongue. And lift up one more time, try to have a long neck. Don't be a turtle. And we'll hiss. Good job. Now some of my elementary ones have done this and some have not. This is airplanes, Superman, and flying squirrels. We try to lift our body off the floor as much as we can. At least our head and our shoulders have to be off the floor. And our hands will be off the floor, and we balance with strong back muscles. And we count to 10. Ready, get set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Superman. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now spread out your arms and legs in a big letter X and lift them all off the floor for flying squirrel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. Fold your legs, grab onto your feet, and pull really tight. Now we'll make a basket. What are you going to put in your basket? I'm going to fill mine with chocolate and maybe some Peeps. You can rock. Okay, now try to touch your toes to your head. Do you think I'll be able to do it today? I'm not sure. If I kick, I can do it. Some of you are way stretchier than me. Now we have to do roly-poly. Sit on your feet and curl into a ball. Do you feel your back relaxing in this position? It's very important after we touch our toes to our head that we always do a roly-poly to unstretch our back. Okay, we're going to stand up now so we can do our standing up exercises like animal walks. Parents, make sure you clear the space around your child so they can move around freely without running into anything or knocking anything over that you might not want broken. Okay, dancers, it's time for animal walks. I'm going to be doing our animal walks in a different direction from how we normally do it as a group. Instead of going from green line to green line, I'm going from the wall to the mirror. Start with bear walks. For an extra challenge, you make your legs straight and do camel walks. Jumping jacks. Do you remember this one? We start with our feet together and we plie three times. One, two, three, jump, feet apart. Then we go again. One, two, three, jump, feet together. Now we go a little faster. One bounce, one jump, one bounce, one jump. And then we do our fast ones. Out, in, out, in, out, in, rest. And we start again. For parents or dance teachers, this exercise is modified from a fantasy garden ballet class with music by Barros and Foster. I'm not using that music because of copyright reasons, but if you can find a copy of the book or DVD, it's a really great resource for pre-ballet. I believe it's out of print, but you might be able to find a used copy on Amazon or eBay. Next, we'll do pique. Do you remember what pique is? That's right. It's the ballet word for prick or a little sharp poke, like when Sleeping Beauty pricked her finger on the spindle of a spinning wheel, something very sharp and pokey. So I'm using a dot. You don't have to use one, but if you want to put something down that you can tap your foot on very gently, you can find something to put down on the floor. Remember that we don't want our foot to go smash, and we also don't want our knee to bend or our foot to go up and down. My whole leg is straight and my whole foot is pointed. I'm going to do three piques with one foot, one, two, three, and then bring my feet together. Then I'll do the other foot, one, two, three, and then bring my foot together. I'm going to put up another version of this exercise for elementary two that is a little bit more challenging. Now we're going to play Find Your Dot. I don't know which dot you want because you're not here, so I'm going to put down a blue and a pink dot, and I'll stand on both of them. When we come back to our dot, we'll do our ballet arms. Let's practice them. First position, keep your thumbs in, and don't lift your arms up too high. They should be right in front of your tummy. Second position, remember it's like hugging a very giant Santa Claus. Don't straighten your arms all the way and don't put your arms behind you. Check and see, are your arms a little bit bendy? Good. And fifth position, this one is like a picture frame. So smile in your picture frame. Are you having a long neck or are your shoulders coming up like this? Pull those shoulders down and be nice and tall with your head. Very good. I'm going to start the music now. It's not our regular Find Your Dot music. Parents, this music is available at balletclassmusicforfree.com. It's a very long URL, but if you type in Ballet Class Music for Free into Google, you'll find it. The music is all by Jefferson Dalby, and it is royalty free to use in any context, so it's a pretty great resource. Thank you. start to dance away from your dot. Exercise to practice marching and skipping. Here's how we'll do it. First, we'll lift up one leg and hold it, switch and hold it, switch and hold it, switch and hold it. Did you count how many steps I did? Four, that's right. So after I do four marching steps, I'm going to do four more, but this time I'm going to go lift my foot, hop, lift my foot, hop, lift my foot, hop, lift my foot, hop. That was another four. Let's try that again. Step, hop, step, hop, step, hop, step, hop. After that, we can skip. Step, hop, step, hop, step, hop, step, hop. We'll do eight skips. You can do them anywhere you want. So first we march very slow, staying in one spot for four steps. Then we step and hop for four steps and still staying in one spot. But when we do our skips, we can skip anywhere we want to go. And then we'll come back to face in front and we'll do it all again. Direction. I'm only going to leap this way, so I'm not going to get a very big running start. I'm guessing you might be in a smaller space than our studio too. So make sure your parent tells you you're in a safe space to leap over. Parents, watch your child when they do this. Make sure they don't go crazy and leap off the couch. Not saying I ever did that as a child, but theoretically it's possible. I did handstands off my couch. My elementary twos have been focusing on knowing which foot to point when we prepare. Do you know which one it is? I'll give you a hint. It's the one that's farthest away from the audience. If you're my audience, that means it's this leg. And if I'm your audience, which foot is it for you? Send me a video if you're not sure, and I'll tell you if you were right or not. We have to remember to hold our arms in first position, run toes first, have your step right before you want to leap. Big leap, reaching our legs very, very straight. Catch your arms and keep running toes first. When we leap, we want to reach our arms into a nice long V with straight arms, and our head does not look at the rivers. It looks straight in front of us, or maybe a little bit up here. Not straight up at the ceiling either, because that makes me look like I have a broken neck. That's not very comfortable, is it? I'm going to use one of our pieces of music that I have used before, but it's not our normal Dangerous River music. This one is from the Firebird. Do you remember me telling you that story about a magical bird who saves a prince from a wicked monster named Katshe? That's a ballet you can find on the internet. It is very exciting. Pointed foot, arms in first position. Are you ready? Here we go. If you have something you can spread out on the floor, like my rivers, you can put a little more space if your parent says it's safe. Make sure you don't leap over anything that you can trip over, like stuffed animals or clothing, especially if you're on a slippery surface like our dance floor. Ready? All together right now, we would practice our dance next. But you're not here, and I'm putting out this video for lots of different classes together. So I'm giving everyone their video of their choreography in a separate video. I haven't gotten to everyone's yet, but I will do that as soon as I can for every single one of you. So next, instead, we'll do goodbye dance. Make sure you have a lot of space and dance however you want. Remember to bow or curtsy at the end, and we'll clap all together. Parents, if you comment below this video or on Facebook or send me an email to say that your child did this dance class, or if you send me a video of your kid dancing, I will put a sticker in their sticker book, and I'm gonna do that on camera at the end of each week with a little extra special something. All right, let's go. Ready? Start to dance however you choose. Thank you. You're a girl, slice your pizza, eat your pizza, take your pizza, slice, eat it. If you're a boy, you just dig into your pizza. And we clap to say thank you for doing ballet class with me today. I'll see you next time. Bye! So have your invisible finger paint right behind your feet, and we'll start with red, painting up and over, and then yellow, paint your rainbow. I forgot orange.